10 differences between US and European Mustangs. Boring European legislation means that US specification Mustangs look cooler and perform better than their European brethren. Here are 10 ways in which they differ. US spec Mustangs get hood vents while European cars do not. You see those cool hood vents on the US spec V8 Mustang? Due to stupid pedestrian safety legislation in Europe, we don't get them. To make up for it though, European cars which come with a performance pack as standard have upgraded radiators compared to base US vehicles. US cars are more powerful. V8 Mustangs in the US are more powerful than those in the United Kingdom. This is because of the right-hand drive conversion needed for the UK, where the V8's exhaust manifold is constrained by the steering shaft. For that reason, a smaller diameter is needed and additional bends are required to clear the shaft. The resulting deficit is 25 horsepower and 9 pound-foot of torque, which translates to 410 horsepower and 391 pound-foot of torque versus 435 horsepower and 400 pound-foot of torque in the US. European Mustang V8s don't get the 3.73 final drive ratio. While we're on the subject of power and performance, the only V8 final drive option in Europe is the 3.55 to 1, while the US car gets the option of the 3.73 3-to-1 Torsen in their performance package version. While this means slightly better acceleration, the trade-off is that 60 miles an hour in the 3.73 occurs right at the top of second gear, which makes a clean shift to third without bouncing off the limiter a little more tricky. Also, with a 155 mile an hour speed limiter deleted, the 3.55 would hit a theoretical top speed of 180 miles an hour versus the 3.73's 178 mile an hour top speed. European Mustangs feature clear lights while those in the US are red. In Europe, the rear lights are clear and feature amber turn lights that flash in one of the three bars. In the US, the taillight bars are red, with the turn indicator working sequentially. While we're at the rear, you'll also notice that the secondary indicators on the Mustang's flanks are orange in Europe and red in America. The headlights on both cars are different too. The EU Mustang headlights have been homologated for Europe and do not use the tri-bar lights as daytime running lights. Instead, the DRLs are integrated in the fog lamps. While the three bars you can see in the European Mustang's headlights look like daytime running lights, they are in fact only reflectors. Europe doesn't get the V6 engine option, and that's good. In fairness, the majority, if not all of Europe, wouldn't care for a V6 Mustang. After all, it's the weakest of the bunch with 300 horsepower, as well as being far less fuel efficient than the 2.3-litre four-cylinder EcoBoost that produces 314 horsepower. And if you Americans thought to hell with fuel economy, then spare a thought for us Europeans, because we pay an average of $7 a gallon, which is three times the price that you guys pay. The door mirrors are fatter on European Mustangs. If you sit both cars next to each other and focus in on their wing mirrors, you'll notice that the power foldable and heated mirrors on the European cars are fatter and more triangular compared to the slimmer and better looking ones on the US version. The reason for the different mirrors is legislation that dictates the mirror height differences, width and shape of the reflective glass. It just so happens that US legislation allowed for better looking mirrors. You can buy a V8 Mustang in the US for the same price as a Focus ST in Europe. The great thing about being an American V8 pony car fan is the fact that Mustangs are made at Ford's Flat Rock Assembly plant in Michigan. This means that the cars don't need to be expensively shipped overseas and that they don't get hit with import taxes. For that reason, an American citizen can walk into any Ford dealer and lay down just $33,000 or £25,000 for an entry-level GT Fastback. For the entry-level V8 Mustang in the UK, we're paying £11,000 more, at almost £36,000, which equates to $47,000. Whichever way you look at it though, the Mustang is an absolute steal in all markets. Right-hand drive cars don't get Recaro seats. If you live in a left-hand drive market, including America, Germany, or any other European market that sells a Mustang, then you have the option of these sweet Recaro seats. But because engineering and homologation costs to offer the right-hand drive Recaros would not have been recouped by Ford, the UK don't get this figure-hugging option. Boo! The buyers. With the iconic Mustang becoming available in Europe for the first time ever, it's no surprise that the mighty V8 has been the engine of choice. On release in the UK, in fact, 70% went for the full fat Freedom Edition, with 30% opting for the EcoBoost. A year later, and those figures haven't changed much, with 68% still in favour of the V8 and 32% going for the 2.3 EcoBoost. Surprisingly, only around 40% of buyers in the US choose the V8, with 34% opting for the EcoBoost, 20% going for the V6, and a brave 6% putting money down on the US-only GT350. So there you have it, 10 differences, some subtle and some not so subtle, between the US spec and European spec Mustang. Let us know what other cars you'd like us to investigate, and don't forget to hit subscribe. If you don't, I will find you, and then I'll probably just cry myself to sleep.